fun. I have bought lots of tiny food. So I saw these bottles here in the store. They are new, as far as I'm concerned. So you can see better. I don't even have a table. Just stack the boxes on top of each other. Three pizzas. These two bottles of Fanta. We have a relatively small ice cream. This is chocolate ice cream. We have a loud spoon. Sorry. Chocolate milkshake without sugar or sweeteners, so that's gonna be gross. Well, it says without added sugar, but like, come on, it's probably some added sugar. I'm gonna put that there, maybe, if that will stay. Okay, then we have a tiny chocolate bar. This is a pretty traditional Norwegian chocolate. And they also make these small chocolate bars, as opposed to the big ones. Well, they also make the big ones. And then I got this, which is not super small, I guess, but it is a, well, it's called a snack pack, and I imagine it's sort of crackers, except it's not crackers. It's something we call knäckebröd, and knäckebröd, I've noticed, is a pretty Scandinavian thing. So if you don't know what that is, you'll see it's kind of just really crunchy bread. It's literally called break bread. Like, knäckebröd, like, it'll break in two halves. We are gonna start with the pizzas and follow it up with the ice cream, because those things are both hot and cold. The other things, they can kind of be whatever temperature. So, here's two tiny pizzas with sriracha sauce that I put on. Wash it down with some blood orange Fanta. I've actually never had this flavor. So this is new to me. And it's pretty good. It's so good. This tiny little tub is, well, how big is it? That is what she said. It's not as much as Ben and Jerry's costs, but this is just plain chocolate, so nothing fancy going on. You know what? I'm actually going to save some. We have this, which is supposedly quite hot, and so I should have something to cool me down if it's extreme. I don't think it's gonna be. Say this is way better than those cheap, brittle, fragile breadsticks that you get in normally with this kind of dip food, you know? The ones that just look like typical Wonder Bread kind of color. This is much better. It was hotter. That's supposed to be the extra hot version. There's another version which is not as hot, and like this, I can barely taste it in terms of spice, so I do wish it was much hotter. But it's pretty much always like that. The only things that get hot enough for me that are like pre-applied heat is like noodles. They tend to be pretty hot, but that's from Asia. Crisps, what Americans would call chips. They can be hot. I suppose when it's applied to carbs and so on, then it tends to be quite hot. Extra spice to counteract the oils in the cheese and so on. Speed this up a little bit, so I'm getting a bit of brain freeze, but since there's very little sound from the ice cream, and I don't want to purposefully go and just like as much as some people would love that, I prefer the natural mouth sounds that occur from eating. Say to shake on this package, they say to turn it upside down before you open, which is kind of funny. taste of much at all, because this is so much sweeter that this without sugar is just like, it's just milk at this point with a little bit of chocolate taste. Starting to come in now, yeah. So yeah, it's chocolate milk. It's pretty tame. Yeah, not very strong flavor of chocolate or sugar or anything like that. Which I suppose makes a lot of sense, considering I've just eaten ice cream, but... yeah, I've tasted a lot better. Small packaging or small food. I'm a huge fan of fucking sounds in my stomach. Jeez. That blood orange mixed with a bunch of other food. Whoa. This is unusual. Okay, so that wasn't as relaxing as I hoped it would be. I'm about to piss every single one of you off. Are you ready? No, I'm not. Not yet. On here, you have the design of a castle. And, yeah, well, you can't see it, but it looks all nice and cute.
Det var en gang en prinsesse som hadde en drøm om en gullkrans, og som følte at uten kransen ville hun ikke leve. En dag i skogen så hun en kvipbjørn som lekte med akkurat den kransen hun hadde drømt om. Han ga den til henne mot at hun flyttet inn hos ham. Bjørnen tok henne med til et fantastisk slott, og der var hun alene alle dagene, mens om natten kom bjørnen og la seg hos henne som et menneske. En gang i året fødte hun et barn som ble tatt fra henne med det samme. Slik levde de i 3 år. Ikke så rart. Prinsessen ble trist og lei. Bjørnen ville trøste, og sa hun skulle få besøke familien sin. Dronningen sendte med datteren et stearinlys, så hun kunne se hvem som lå hos henne om nettene.
My nose is itchy. Sorry.
Det var en smellvakker mann som det var en smellvakker mann som det var selveste kong Valemann. Han ble sint da hun så, for det var bare en måned til så ville trolldommen være over, og han ble mann på heltid. Nå ble han bjørn igjen og løp av gårde. Jenta hang seg fast i pelsen, men måtte slippe taket og mistet ham av syne. På sin vei for å finne kong Valemann traff hun tre kjæringer med hver sin nydelige jente, som alle ga prinsessen magiske gaver. Den ene var en gullsaks som lagde klær bare man klippet i luften. Den andre var en flaske som aldri ble tom, og den tredje var en duk som tryllet frem all slags mat. Til slutt fant hun kongen hos trollkjæringa, som hadde tryllet ham om til en bjørn, og som skulle tvangsgifte ham med seg. There's spelling mistakes in here, and typos. It's weird. Takke være gavene og en felle prinsessen la for trollkjæringa, kunne hun ta med kongen og rømme derfra med masse gull og sølv. De hentet de tre småjentene som var deres egne døtre og holdt bryllup både lenge og vel. Now I'm gonna go back to whispering. Story in the middle is a bit of a pleasant surprise to some and to others. Well, others are not watching anymore, so. And if you are in Norwegian and you were listening to me speak, you would hear that I find it difficult to read. It's not because I'm an idiot, it's because, well, partly grammar mistakes are pretty rampant in there, but Jesus Christ. Stock.